All right, we are going to do a comparison between the InSonic APS Classic and the Akai S950. Two distinct filter types from two samplers that were brought out relatively around the same time. And we'll see what we come up with and hopefully shed some light on why we choose different samplers for different sonic applications. But before that, I'd like to invite you to like, share, and subscribe to our humble sampler channel. It's much appreciated. And with that, let's get on with it. So the first thing we're gonna do is sample our source material into the Akai S950 and the EPS Classic. Now, these are 12-bit and 13-bit samplers respectively, but they are both capable of sampling at 44.1 kHz. So we'll just get things ready to go, and here's our source material. Nice. Now what we're going to do to conduct this comparison as accurately as possible, we're going to listen to percentage levels of each filter. So in other words, 100% would be both filters on both samplers 100% open, 50% would be halfway closed, and so forth. And for this test, I've chosen percentages of 100, 75, 50, 25, and 10%. And this will give us a good overall reference to compare these two samplers and what they sound like at varying degrees. So now we'll set the filters of both samplers 100% open and listen to what they sound like back to back. Right, so that's with no filter at all. So now dialing down to 75%, let's have another listen. Okay, so from here on out, we'll listen straight through from 50% all the way down to 10% without any interruptions to hear what these samplers sound like back to back. Okay, so immediately what I'm hearing, it's pretty obvious, is there's some sort of bump, almost like a slight resonance with the Akai, whereas the InSonic EPS is pretty flat across the board. What's also worth noting is that the EPS filter is a digital filter, while the Akai S950 is an analog filter. However, the sound of these two filters definitely lends themselves to different creative applications. You can tell that one filter would sound better on a certain type of thing, and that thing is really up to you and your personal taste, but because they're so different, you can definitely find favorable results with either one. And this is why filters are important. How they affect sounds plays a big role into how that sound fits into your music, which is why when we're looking for samplers, we immediately want to know, well, what does a filter sound like? Because when we know what a filter can do with a sound, we then know how we would use the filter in our music. Yeah? Anyway, thank you for listening. If you liked and learned something today, subscribe to us here on YouTube. We really appreciate it. I will catch you on the next one. In the meantime, take care of yourself. Peace.